Jesus when sin and death came against him. Mm-hmm. He comes to shepherd our souls mm-hmm. into the place that we see we have no lack because mm-hmm. we've been braided together mm-hmm. with yes. God. Mm-hmm. He comes to cause yes. us to lie down mm-hmm. and he puts our hearts at rest. He wow. leads us beside the still waters of grace where we see that our strength is God and his grace, mm-hmm. not our own strength, right? He comforts us. He shows us the table God prepared for us in the midst of the death surrounding us in this world. Yea, though we walk through the valley shadowed by death, we see God prepared a table of life for us. Yeah. That table of life he prepared for us, we feed on it, and it comforts us. It fills us with abundance where we begin to say, my cup runneth over. I mean, that's what the Spirit come to do,
yeah.
right? It come to tell you when the death that's in the world is trying to tell you God's abhorred you in your affliction. He's hid his face from you. He doesn't hear you when you cry out to him. Look at you. The Spirit comes inside of you and says, God have not abhorred you in your affliction. Neither is he hiding his face from you. But he hears you when you cry, right? And he starts guiding you into the place where you start to see this union you have with God. This thing God did to conquer death, to conquer your bully. And you start getting happy. You start, I don't lack anything. And then when you see you don't lack anything, your soul's been shepherded into a place of abundance. Then you start to rest. Right?
Yeah.
And then you start to see that it's by the arm of God and not by your own arm. Mm-hmm. Right?
Amen.
I